Hi, so today I'm going to talk about macarons cracking. So if you make your macarons and you pipe them out and after they've dried and you bake them and they're getting like volcano tops and they're cracked and you just can't get a smooth shell, these tips might help. So there's a lot of different reasons why your macarons might be cracked, but I'm just going to name some of the reasons and some things to experiment with. But like I've said in this video and all my other videos, only change one thing at a time when you're trying to fix a problem. So don't go and use all of these tips at once next time you make macarons, but go and change one thing at a time. Okay, so one reason your macarons could be cracking is your oven is too hot. So if you have watched any of my other troubleshooting videos, you know that I really recommend you get an oven thermometer. Okay, even just baking anything, get an oven thermometer, but especially with macarons, because who knows what your temperature actually is in your oven. Even if you have a brand new oven, it still might be off. So new ovens, old ovens, any oven needs an oven thermometer. Because I had someone ask me recently, why, what's the point if your oven's the right temperature? You don't know if it's the right temperature. And you wanna make sure it's consistently the right temperature. For macarons anyway. So get an oven thermometer. And another reason they could be cracking is if all of like half of the macarons in your oven come out fine and then there's like a certain area on the tray that's always cracking, that can be hot spots in your oven. So if you get an oven thermometer, put it into different areas of your oven and see what the actual temperature is. See if there's hot spots in there. And if there is, it's not the end of the world. You could just rotate your tray halfway through. I used to rotate it halfway through when I had an oven that wasn't that great. So that's something you could do. Like if your oven is not that new, don't get too sad about that because you can always rotate your trays halfway through the baking time. I used to even rotate them 3 times, but opening up the oven that much while they're baking wasn't great for it. So if you can, just rotate it once if you have to, if there's hot spots. If you're enjoying this video and you want to see more like it, hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it to be notified whenever I come out with a new video. Now, another reason why your macarons could be cracking is because you're not slamming the tray down after you pipe the shells. So once you pipe them all out, you should slam the tray down on the counter like I do, like 3 times, 2 times, but I slam it really hard. So maybe just a couple times, at least just a couple times, slam them down, and that should help with the cracking because if there's air bubbles inside the macarons that aren't released, that can lead to kind of those exploding shells. Okay, another reason your macarons are cracked could be not whipping the meringue enough. So I made a whole video about that right here because that is an important step when making macarons. So go watch that and make sure you're whipping it enough because this is not like whipped cream where you have to really, really be careful about over whipping. You have a little more room for error when you're whipping your meringue. So this is not like whipped cream. You can really get this to a stiff peak. So if you have a bunch of little cracks over your macarons and it looks like really dry dirt, that's like, you know what I mean? That's like a dirt floor that's really dry, that's cracking all over. That could be from not whipping your meringue enough. But if it's more like volcanoes, that's probably not from not whipping enough. So, but if they're tiny little cracks over the surface, then that's probably from not whipping your meringue enough. Okay, now another reason your macarons could be cracking is not resting the piped shells long enough. So after you pipe the macarons, you need to let them sit. For most recipes, for the recipe I use here, I really recommend letting them rest. But some people that are in drier climates, they don't have to. I have always had to, and a lot of people that I've taught have had to rest them. And if they don't, they crack. So if you're just starting, I would rest them. But if you're an experienced baker, then you can kind of try not resting or oven resting or using one of those methods. But if you're getting cracked macarons and you've gone through all these other tips, you could try leaving them out a little longer. So you pipe the shells, you let them sit at room temperature and wait for like a kind of a skin to form. That sounds gross. Kind of the top just gets smoother so it's not sticky. I let them go until it's like a smoother, slightly tougher shell. Like you can't really, they're not really soft anymore, but it's kind of a little harder. That's what I like to do to get a really sturdy kind of bite before you get to the soft center of the macaron. But experiment with resting time, especially if it's like one of those volcano cracks where, and if it's happening to your first trays in your batch, but not the last trays. So if the macarons that haven't been sitting out as long are the ones that are cracking always, that's probably a resting thing. So let the first ones rest a little longer. And you probably won't have to worry too much about the last ones resting too long, because that's usually a couple hours. You don't really have to worry, if you're making a smaller batch, about the last trays resting too long. Okay, now another reason your macarons could be cracking is too much liquid in the shells. I like to put as little liquid as possible in the shell, and if you're just starting out, I would go with no liquid. Don't put food coloring, not even gel food coloring. I wouldn't put anything in the shell when you're just starting out. I would try to get a white shell or just whatever is a natural color shell with no food coloring. And flavoring. I still don't really put flavoring in the shell, but if you are putting food coloring or some sort of extract in your shell and they're cracking, that could be why. I see a lot of people, their macarons will crack when they're doing like a swirl of color, or they are dripping food coloring down the edge of their bag before they put the batter in the piping bag. Then they crack a lot. That can be the food coloring. So experiment with no food coloring first if you're just starting. Then if you can get the macarons down without any cracks, then add a little bit of food coloring. Then you can tell if that's where the cracks are coming from. Okay, and another reason your macarons could be cracking, it could just be a bad recipe. I've said this a lot, to find a recipe you like and stick with it. But if you keep getting cracked macarons and you're doing the exact same thing every time, and you've tried all of these other things and it's still cracking, try this recipe. This recipe I use every single day, and a lot of other people have had success with this one. So try that. I know for a fact that it will work. You just maybe half it or something when you're first starting, so you don't have to waste a lot of macarons. If you want to start selling your macarons or any other baked goods, you want to start a home bakery business, join the email list below. I have a course called The Home Bakery Blueprint where you can work with me to start or grow your home bakery business. So join that and I will email you when spots open up for that course. Okay, and if you are still getting cracked macarons and you have other problems with your macarons, join the Michelle's Macarons Facebook group and post your pictures in there, and we will all help you troubleshoot and figure out what's wrong with your macarons. If you'd like, you can follow me on Facebook and Instagram. It's Michelle's Macarons, and I'll put those links in the description. Okay, check out these other macaron videos. Okay, love you, bye.